There is currently an outbreak of Ebola in the Democratic Republic of Congo. Now, it's the largest outbreak the DRC has had and the second largest outbreak ever recorded. Now, one worry is that someone who has symptoms may travel to neighbouring countries like Uganda, Rwanda and South Sudan and accidentally spread the disease. What healthcare workers want to avoid is a bigger outbreak affecting more people, like the outbreak in West Africa a few years ago. It hit countries like Liberia, Guinea, Sierra Leone and Nigeria, with more than 28,500 people who were reported to have suffered from the disease. Over 11,000 people died. In 2016, the World Health Organization declared the last of those countries, which was Liberia, Ebola-free. Now, there needs to be 42 days without any new cases for a country to be declared Ebola-free. Now, there are three big reasons why getting this outbreak of Ebola under control is difficult. Firstly, there's been a lot of violent conflict in the DRC. Secondly, the places where Ebola has been found are in villages that are far away from other villages, so people may not have even heard of the Ebola disease. And because of those other reasons, thirdly, those communities don't trust health workers who've come to help them. There have been angry exchanges about the way health workers have tried to help, with some treatment centres being attacked.
Au niveau des CTE classiques,
Ebola treatment centers are now becoming modern and we are starting to use these cubes. They are transparent and that allows us to combat the rumors going around the community. And in terms of the medical care, they help in case of emergencies.
One way healthcare workers are trying to make sure the disease does not spread is in how they're vaccinating people. They call it the ring vaccination. So, if someone has symptoms, healthcare workers will ask who they've been in contact with and vaccinate them. They'll ask that person the same question. Who have you been in contact with? Call those people in and their friends and vaccinate them, and so on and so on. So as many people as possible will be vaccinated against the disease, even if they're not showing any symptoms. In the meantime, there are a number of different vaccines under research as scientists try to find the best one to help people.